In this video, you will learn the basics of accessing and navigating your course in Moodle. Let's start off by looking at how to find and enter each of your courses. Once logged into Moodle, navigate to My Courses to see your list of courses. There are two tabs at the upper left of the screen in the middle. Be sure you have selected the one that says Courses. This will bring you to a screen that has tabs for courses that are in progress, future courses, and past courses. Simply click on the In Progress tab and enter the course you wish to access. The Timeline tab will lead you to a screen where you can see upcoming and overdue assignments that need your attention. To the right of the assignment title, there is an option to complete the assignment to the right. Going back to the Courses tab, I will now enter a course. To enter a course, I simply select the link with the course section number on it. Once in the course, you will start at the top and work your way down through the course using the scroll bar or the scroller on your mouse. Many instructors will add an introduction to the course, the syllabus quiz, and other important information about the course in the top section. Many instructors add their contact information in an instructor block on the right, so students will always have convenient access to the instructor's contact information. If this block is not included in your course, then all of the information about your instructor will be provided in the syllabus. There are two parts to the syllabus at Craven Community College. There's Syllabus Part 1 and Syllabus Part 2. They will be available in the top block of the Moodle course. Part 1 includes specific course information, and Part 2 includes important policies and procedures. All online and hybrid courses require students to take a syllabus quiz to be counted present in the course prior to the census date. Be sure to read the syllabi first, and then take the syllabus quiz as soon as possible before the census date. Instructors will communicate the census date to you, so be looking for that important date so you are not withdrawn from the course. Next, let's take a look at the course navigation indicated at the top with three straight lines. Selecting this will give you the option to view the participants in the course, access badges and competencies, and your grades. Below that, each section of the course is listed so you can easily navigate through the course without having to do as much scrolling through the center content area of the course. Continuing down, there are more links that give you access to the calendar, to your private files, where you can upload files for your own use, and more. Next, let's take a look at the course dashboard. Navigate up to the top left of the course and select the gear icon. This opens a window where you can see your instructor's name, email address, and the option to send a message to your instructor. In addition, at the top right is where you will be able to access your grades. All of the course activities are listed in a column on the right, including assignments, external tools, forums, journals, quizzes, and resources that are available to you by using these links. Up at the top of the Moodle page, there are menu items that students may find helpful. By selecting the downward arrow next to the student resources, you will find links to Craven CC Online, the DL Student Orientation, Office 365 Instructions, and the New Student Orientation. If you get stuck and need help, there's a Need Help item on the menu leading to an external 24/7 help desk and the Academic Skills Center here at Craven Community College. The main content of your course will be posted in sections in Moodle. So in this course, we can see section titles across the middle, and we notice that each section is closed. To open course sections, click the arrow to the left of the section, and it will open up the content inside of the section for you to use during your learning. Finally, there are blocks to the right of your course content area that you may find helpful. So let's scroll back up to the top of the course and take a look at some of the blocks. as mentioned before, this is the instructor block. There's a search forums block, a people block, where you can see the other participants in the course. There's an upcoming events block that is tied to the calendar. Again, here are all of the activity links that will take you to each activity type. There are course categories, other tools, a calendar block, and latest news. Each course may vary in the blocks provided for students. You can always return to the Moodle homepage up at the top left by selecting the home button. So that's it. Thank you for joining me to learn how to navigate your course in Moodle.